Man, I just left it all out there, honestly. Tried to hit him as hard as I can, and I knew that some way, somehow, the ball would hopefully come out. And when I got up, I saw Bilal and Roquan fumbling with it a little bit, but I knew one of them would come out with it, so it was good to see that.
After those first two series, they pretty much ran the ball. After about that a little bit?
Yeah, but we expected it with the gust of winds and the weather for this game, obviously. But, you know, we're a tough defense, and we have a lot of things to fix, and we're going to keep working on those things and just keep giving it all we have.
Earlier in the year, you said you were 20 biggest improvements was playing with more confidence. What's your confidence level right now?
Man, you know, it only continues to grow. You know, I have left some opportunities out there this season, and I know what I have to work on this upcoming offseason, but as far as opportunities, man, and my confidence, it goes hand to hand. You know, when I do miss opportunities, you know, it might not go up a little bit, but when I do make those big chances and those big plays, you know, it skyrockets more than it stays flat. So that's a good thing.
Can you talk about being behind Khalil Mack and Robert Quinn and getting your chance and performing like you have today?
You know, It's a great opportunity and a great blessing to be able to play behind those two guys, you know, two gold jackets soon to be. And, you know, I couldn't ask for anything else. You know, a lot of guys, I want to play, I want to do this and that. But I'm literally behind two pass rushers that probably top five in the league. And, you know, it's technique, film. I get to watch their steps every day, you know, from sun up to sundown. So I'm in a great position, and you know, I honestly couldn't be more appreciative.
Were you one of the guys who was on Quinn all game, asking when he was going to get that sack?
Nah, I know Robert Quinn real well. We're in the same room, so I know what he's capable of doing. And it was only a matter of time till he achieved that goal. So many blessings for him, and you know, it's a great experience to be able to watch that. Honestly,
how much do you appreciate just his season compared to what he went through last year?
You know, it's mind-blowing because, you know, when you're winning, everybody likes you, but when you're losing, you're losing, and nobody really is a fan of it. So, you know, he got a lot of down talk this year or last year, and this year, you know, he shut everybody up. He just set the record for the Chicago Bears, a great franchise. So, you know, that'll go down in history, and I'm just appreciative to be able to watch and observe it.
And what have you learned from him, both as a player and a person?
How to be a pro. You know, I'm obviously still young. This is my second year, but being able to see how those guys take care of their body, how they watch film, how they critique themselves, you know, just a mountain of things in the pass rush world that, you know, I don't think I could get anywhere else, honestly.
He talked about overcoming what he said was a quote-unquote terrible season is nothing compared to what he's been through and overcoming that. And what do you admire about just the person that he's been as a player and a professional?
For lack of words, he's a warrior. He almost died when he was younger. Still rushing the passer today. You know, he overcomes battles. That's what he does. And, you know, I'm real happy for him, honestly. Really happy for him. You know, he did something that nobody else has done. And we all got to witness that today. So I think we should be appreciative to be able to witness history, especially in the Chicago Bears organization.
It had been almost 3 months since you guys had multiple takeaways in a game. What did it feel like out there today to see them come in a little bit of a swarm today?
It felt good, man. You know, that's what the defense is about. We want to be about takeovers or turnovers and get the ball back to our offense as fast as possible. So just going out there, flying around, you know, after we get a turnover, pointing which way to run and where the camera, you know, people sliding. It's just fun, man. It's an amazing game, man.
Trevis, we're starting to get used to seeing that sack dance of yours, man. I like it. What exactly are you doing?
Man, so I'm a fan of Avengers and Marvel. So I'm a fan of Thor specifically. So I like to get the hammer, hit it twice on the ground, and then get rid of it, go on to the next play, honestly.
Well, what was your mindset in the game, and how significant was your performance today for you?
You know, my mindset going into this game is I have two opportunities left to leave everything that I can on the field. You know, tomorrow isn't promised, but it's the first game of 2022. You know, it's no other thing that I would want to be able to play this game starting off the year. So, you know, it was a great opportunity. I felt like I took advantage of it. I did leave some players out there, but, you know, with those opportunities, it teaches you how to grow. Where you, what you need to do, the things you need to fix in order to take that step in the right direction.
Trevis,
Charles, we've heard Khalil talk about his development as a pass rusher in terms of not just wanting to get to the quarterbacks and necessarily hit them, but specifically to get to the football. Have you learned that from him, and have you seen that kind of translate onto the field for you in your game?
Most definitely. Yeah, you know, he doesn't honestly, I don't even think he cares about the quarterback. He cares about the ball. And, you know, hearing that repetitively in our room from those guys, him and Robert Quinn, you know, I think it's sort of just setting in on me, like, man, you can still get the sack fumble if you hit the ball. You know, you don't just have to get the sack. You get more when you hit the ball. So, you know, that's something that I've taken into my pass rush. And, you know, I feel like I'm appreciative for those guys and what they preach and talk.
Okay, thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Charles.
Thank you.